Hi, folks. Welcome back to the Hoard. Nice day. Drying out. Good day to be outside. Anyway, for those of you who are familiar with the Hoard, you know that there are four cars that are registered on the road. Actually, two cars and two trucks. So I have two Corollas, this Tacoma, and I have a Ford Ranger. The Ford Ranger, I've owned this truck since she's been new, and it has a real easy life, and perhaps too easy because the battery died. And as a matter of fact, the last couple of times I went to take it out, the battery was dead. So the battery is a Duracell, made by Johnson Controls, as a lot of the batteries here in the USA are made by Johnson Controls. And yeah, it turns 17. K is December, and 1 is probably 2011. So I guess it turns 6 in December. And it's got a it's got a 3-year free replacement, 8-year prorated. So assuming I had the receipt, they'd probably, I don't know, what is the battery? $80. 80 yeah, 7 times 12, call it 84. So if I brought it back, they'd give me $14 toward another battery. But what I decided to do is, though this is supposedly a sealed battery, with a little screwdriver action and so forth, you can make it an unsealed battery, right, by prying this lid off. And then you could take a look in here, and as you could see, that cell, see the metal, that cell, actually the whole battery looks like it can use some water. So I have some distilled water here, and I'm going to top it up, and then I'm going to charge the heck out of it, right to the point where they call it float charging, where all the cells are bubbling away for all they're worth. And then I'm going to see if it'll hold a charge. So maybe, maybe not. I've looked through my hoarder batteries. Like, this is a nice new battery. It's only a little over a year old. But the positive terminal is kind of on the wrong side. And this guy, though the positive terminal's on the proper side, it's too tall to go in the truck. So one of the junkyards around me, Maltz as it's known, a little distance, I don't know, half hour away, they sell used batteries, and they get $30 for them. So if you got a new battery, I think that battery new, once again, if you go over to Sam's Club, you pay somewhere around 90. So if you could get the right one for 30, and it's this year's battery, it's kind of worth it. But if you go in there and you get a battery that's already 2 years old, and you don't know how well it was treated, especially if it's not a big guy, the bigger batteries seem to have more amps. So if they're mistreated and they lose a few amps, you know, not that you're happy about that, but you deal with it. So we'll see. I guess we'll find out over the next day or so if this thing holds a charge. Anyway, I guess basically, I've seen that once again, batteries have a tendency to get a little weak and all if they are low on water. So I'm going to try to add water, try a full charge, see if it brings it back. It may not. By the way, basically beating on a battery with a screwdriver and a hammer, and you got acid there and all kinds of other stuff. So if you are going to try this, please be careful, right? A face full of acid doesn't do anybody any good. And you also want to be careful that you don't, you know, like smash the screwdriver into one of the cells, because you can short the cell, you know. And depending, once again, if the battery's charged or that particular cell is well charged, the thing could go boom in your face. And once again, acid in the face, not such a good thing. All right, folks, we'll see if it works. Folks, I want to thank you all for watching and commenting and subscribing. Please keep your feet down, keep your heads up, and get out there and enjoy all your days. Bye now, folks.